Hello, hello everyone, and welcome! My name is JONI, and this is a Devlog series on my game Omapeli. Omapeli will be a 3D action role-playing game where you have to survive in a medieval fantasy world that is filled with magic and magic-infused creatures. There will be an attribute and leveling system for skills other than magic there, and well, the magic works differently, but more about that in my future videos. The game is still in a very early phase, as you can see from the video next to me. Basically, you can roam in an infinite world, but the world is not yet that interesting, nor there are many things to do yet. Currently, I'm working to first create a basic gameplay loop that is interesting, and then create a world that gives you an atmosphere similar to the one that I'm planning for. It is a long road ahead, but luckily I'm sharing this journey with you guys, so it's not gonna be lonely. But without further babbling, let's get to the business. The next 3 minutes or so I'll be solely talking about the Panda3D game engine that I use. Okay, let's go. In general, all the games nowadays use something called a game engine that is essentially just a software stack designed for creating video games. Some of the most used and well-known game engines today are Unity, Unreal and Godot, for example. To create Omapeli, I use the Panda3D game engine and the Python programming language. It is an open source 3D game engine that was initially released in 2001. It benefits from decades of commercial, academic and hobbyist development work. The most well-known games made using it are probably the Toontown Online and the Pirates of the Caribbean Online games that both were released in the early 2000s. Panda3D comes with many useful features. On desktop, it has good platform support for Windows, Mac, Linux and FreeBSD. On mobile and web, however, the support for Android, iPhone and WebGL are still in development. Personally, I selected Panda3D because I enjoy programming using Python. And in Panda3D, Python is a first-class citizen. You can also use Panda3D using the C++ programming language, and the C++ site is equally well documented. But I think most people prefer Python for rapid prototyping. The Panda3D community is small but active. The main communication channel is the discussion forum that can be directly accessed from the Panda's homepage. The oldest posts go all the way back to 2005, so the works at Panda have done great work preserving all that accumulated knowledge and history. If you cannot find an existing solution to a problem similar to yours, just asking pretty much guarantees an answer. And finally, the gem of Panda, the manual. The manual gives a complete introduction to 3D programming using either Python or C++ to command the Panda. And as you can see, you can select between the Python and the C++ versions of the documentation at the top left corner. The programming with Panda3D section covers nearly everything that one needs to create a working game. For example, how to work with 3D models in the scene graph, and how to add things like texturing, shaders, sounds, particle physics, and networking to your game. The other sections include information about debugging, performance optimization, releasing, and other tools that Panda3D includes. Very useful, interesting, and generally very pleasant to read. The most important part of the manual, to my mind, is the API reference. Here you can find all the functions and classes available to you in the Panda3D. Overall, the quality of documentation is great, to the point and concise. Okay, That was my rant about Panda3D. I think this engine is a great pick for my game project Omapeli. If you have any additional reasons for or against Panda3D, please leave your comments below. Especially I'm interested to hear how it compares to any other game engine that you have used, as personally I have only used 2D game engines before. This was my first devlog ever, I hope you liked it. In the next devlog I'll be looking how to make grass. See you next time!